Hi and welcome. My name is Catherine with StyleCat Pro, and today I'm bringing you a StyleCat Spotlight interview. Really loving these interviews because I just find them so fascinating. I love bringing people to you that can bring some great information. So I am bringing today, it's all about image, which I think is a really important subject. Image for women entrepreneurs, how our image reflects our brand, the iconicness of it all. And I couldn't think of a better person to bring forward than Jenny P. Parker Brown, who is the CEO and founder of the House of Preeminence magazine. She's also a style philosopher and a quantum messaging maven. I mean, she's an amazing woman. I'm so excited for you to meet her. And I just want you to know she has a plethora of great topics to talk on. So we'll be doing a series of interviews with her, but today it's really focusing on image. So Jenny, could you just kind of jump in and tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yes, thank you. Thank you for inviting me to talk about something that we're both really passionate about. Absolutely so passionate about. Style and beauty have always been important to me. I started off training as a ballet dancer. So I was always into, you know, beauty and form and clothes and the stage. And then I did a few beauty shows. And then I had a spell in my career where I was in fashion retailing and also passionate about window dressing and about merchandising and, you know, and how color and form contributes to, you know, to marketing. But basically, I also had, a gorgeous mum who was my inspiration. She passed away last year. She was an elegant lady. She was a paragon of elegance and grace and good taste. I was just remembering this morning, actually, as I walked through the woods, that her wardrobe was always heaving with clothes. That was her little péché mignon, her little, her little sin. She couldn't resist clothes, and she could afford to buy, you know, to buy them regularly. So I grew up with the idea that, you know, that style was important to a life of success and luxury. And actually, what I discovered over my life and career was that me turning up as my highest self, you know, inside and out, was the way that I managed to attract so many incredible adventures, a lot of careers, as you know, because we've known each other for 10 years, which go through, as I said, fashion retailing, into fine dining, into chateau restoration, into coaching, into publishing, into even being a professional dancer, again, at the age of 41. Mm-hmm. And also as being a horse dancer, which is another of my dreams come true, as you know. And I have to say that taking care of myself and my style and image was key to creating those opportunities to, you know, to actually making things happen. And there is a little bit of a science to this, which we will go on to.
Oh, good. Yeah. And you've also done a lot of modeling too. I'm just going to add that in because Jenny's been an amazing model for my hats for many years. I'm always happy to have them on her head because she looks so great. But you have a great sense of style, you know, and that I think is such an important aspect to anybody to just really claim their own style. But I want to talk to you about why image is so important to the entrepreneurial woman, especially right now. Like what about one's style represents their work? Is that happening right now? Is that important? I mean, I know it's important, but I want you to talk about it.
Okay, so there was a cliche which still stands, which is dress for success. It kind of rolls off everybody's lips. And I just want to talk about why it is actually a science. Is that when we meet people, the brain takes 3 seconds to decide whether we're going to like that person or not. Three seconds. And we can be look at them and thinking about something completely different and looking as if we're talking and engaging, but actually the brain's already decided if you're going to like that person or not. And you know, in this world of socializing, even virtual socializing, connection and engagement with people is key. And even people, you know, visiting your website, is people are subconsciously analyzing you, you know, in the first few seconds. But you can use your style and image to capture people's attention. So, you know, so that dressing for success is part of it, and it's never left us. And I'll explain why. Is that, you know, our human reptilian brain is always looking to belong. We want to belong to people, you know, we want to belong. We're instinctively finding out who's our tribe, if we resonate with somebody, not just if they're going to be a client, you know, or if we're going to work together, or if we're going to fall in love with them, but we are actually working out if we're in the same tribe, you know. And we do that by assessing people's values quickly. So for example, if you go to a party where you don't know anybody, or you know a few people, the first thing you're going to do is you're going to look around at how people have turned up, mm-hmm. who's there and how have they turned up. And the first thing that you're going to notice, even instinctively, is who looks like you. In other words, who has a similar energy or vibe or even appearance. For example, if you go to a party and you happen to have a boho mystical style, be a bit kind of hippie chic, or not chic, and you go to a party and you see somebody else dressed in paisley or, you know, or a long skirt and lace and some beads, you are immediately going to, you know, your radar is already out. Of course, it could be a man. It's not, mm-hmm. not just, you know, between women. And the opposite is true. If you have a very structured, chic, clean, you know, high black high heels and red dress sort of outfit, then you're going to notice somebody who's got a similar vibe. So we naturally do this instinctive assessing of people when we meet them, and not just when we meet them for the first time, but every single time we come into contact with them. So there really is you know, a science behind this, because now when we so need to capture, entrepreneurs need to capture their audience and hold their audience, they can use their appearance and their energy to, you know, to hold that and to go further and to enroll them and to have conversations and connections. Mm-hmm. So the thing is, here's the thing, to dress up is to honor those who perceive us.
Yes.
You know, and this, and I know you'll agree with me on this, is lamentably something that's gone really downhill in this era of home business, when people are much more informal, much more casual, there's this whole dressing down thing which is going on, which is really not serving entrepreneurs at all. Because how do you feel? You throw a dinner party, for your friends, and they dress up to come, and you feel honored. You mm-hmm. feel honored because they made an effort and they dressed up. So there's another kind of energetic vibe going on between you. So if you turn up for people and you've made an effort and you look pretty in your, or pretty or beautiful or stylish, or, you know, preeminent in your own authentic way, then people are going to feel honored. They're going to feel important. And how important is that people feel important?
Right. And especially in business, that would be a big deal. You know, you want to have that inner feeling when you're in business. You want to feel powerful when you're communicating. So that makes sense, you know.
Level. And then there's another aspect, scientific aspect to it, and this is science and an art, is that, and this is what the magazine House of Preeminence is all about, is the way that law of attraction, good old law of attraction works, which is a universal principle that affects us everything in life, every single day, at all times, in every single place in the world, at every moment, is like attracts like. So if you turn up for your business and your clients as if you are already in a place of your most successful self, then you are actually accelerating the process of your success. So this principle called be, do, have the other day, is if you want to have something, have more clients, have more money, have more freedom, you've got to be that first and embody it in every way. So here's the thing, is that often we get up in the morning and we meditate and we do our miracle morning routine, you know, work out, do yoga, our rituals, journal, have a shower, potter around, go for a walk, whatever it is, and then we get dressed. But the getting dressed is actually the most important part. Mm-hmm. because what we need to do is to dress all of that inner work that we've just done. So if we're doing affirmations, and I highly recommend, you know, people do affirmations every day, and then we just sling on anything, it's almost out of alignment, because it's saying, well, the outside part of me doesn't matter, you know, it's like, and that is not true.
Yeah, I agree. The for women entrepreneurs, I mean, in your thought, what do you think are the biggest things that they have to contend with, besides just the idea that, you know, they're running their businesses probably while running their households and all of that, but are there other factors in there that are involved that could be shifted in their style, like if they were to really focus on that?
It's true that women are juggling now more than ever so many roles, you know, women entrepreneurs juggling so many roles as CEO of your own company, as you know, mum, as partner, as friend, as mastermind buddy, as collaborator. We have got so many, you know, as house manager or gardener, whatever, but we are juggling so many roles. It can be really challenging to, you know, to give our style and image the priority that it needs. But here's the thing is, you know, as we're well aware of, the market is saturated. Every market is saturated, and it's saturated not just with other entrepreneurs, it's saturated by the amount of information there is going on online. I was going to take these off because they're a little bit dazzling. I can see my reflection in them. I could put them back on to read my notes. And also by the overload of distractions that people have. So we're actually competing for people's attention. You know, women entrepreneurs are competing for people's attention, not just competing with other entrepreneurs in their topic, but competing for people's attention. And there's also this phenomenon of entrepreneurs often, because the markets are saturated, is that they actually look and sound like everybody else. You know, even their styles like everybody else, their websites like everybody else, their vocabulary, their pitch, everything is like everybody else. So that another reason to stand out with their style and image. And also what they're contending with is the guru domination. You know, the gurus have, especially the younger generations coming on, that the millennials and the new ones are rising, so women need to put every single tool that they've got in their, you know, in their bag, in their bag of tricks, into building a business and feeling good as well, because this isn't just about building a business. This is about feeling feeling gorgeous and being radiant.
Yeah, and feeling like your own self instead of just feeling like you're cookie cutter. It makes me think, as we're having this conversation, the conference that you went to with all the red dresses, which I thought was such an interesting story. So I know it's a little off track. I mean, we do have notes here, so we're trying to keep on. But I would love you to talk about that, because I think it really relates to the fact that when it comes to style, it's personal. Personal style is what's going to emanate the best. It's going to resonate the best, and it's going to attract the best. So I would love if you could just tell us that story, because it's I think it's eye-opening myself.
I never get tired of telling this story.
I know you don't. I know. I'm like, it wasn't on our list of questions, but it should be.
No, it amuses me every single time. So I travel regularly for events, conferences, you know, networking events and speaking events and conferences. And one thing that I've noticed is that women tend to, you know, they tend to dress alike. So there was one particular event that I attended last year with 100 women in. There was 100 women in the room, and at least 12 of them were all wearing a red dress. Now, red dresses are seen as power dressing, and women often resort to red dresses. And it's amazing, you know, how women think that a red dress is power dressing, but it isn't necessarily. If it doesn't suit you and it doesn't suit your skin tone and your energy or your business. For example, if the ladies thought it was so hilarious that there were so many red dresses there, that they actually lined themselves up and took a photo of themselves, but you know, all together. So here's the thing. Amongst those ladies, you couldn't tell which one was a Reiki master, which one was an accountant, which one was a relationship coach, which one was a mindset coach, because they all looked the same, exactly the same. And some of them not in the most tasteful way either. So even the lady who one of the speakers was actually a TEDx speaker, and who's had over a million views on her TEDx talk. And this wasn't just my observation. A friend of mine came to me and said, "Don't you think there's something slightly off about her wearing a red dress?" And I said, "Definitely. She's a Viking, blonde, tall, blonde Viking with blue eyes and very pale skin, and the red did not do any service to her. Okay, she's very successful, but there was a dissonance. There was a dissonance." And somebody else said this exactly the same thing to me. And again, if women have their signature style, which is you know, something that is absolutely unique to every single woman, not only will she not look like anybody else in the whole world, it actually totally simplifies the whole styling and dressing every day. So with this busy lifestyle that we were talking about, when you've got a signature style, you don't even have to think about it anymore, being, you know, having a polished look.
Right. And it has to do with colors and just shapes and everything. I mean, I loved it. I love to have you tell your red dress story, when in fact my favorite dress that I own is a red dress. I look stellar in it. It's totally my signature. But I spent a long time looking for the right shade of red. Not every shade of red works for everybody, you know? So when you do find it, if that is one of your colors, then it's a great thing. But I can just picture this whole thing of, like, you know, several shades, and just they can wash people out and whatnot. So it really does matter, you know.
You're a deep winter palette. You're a deep winter, you know. Skin palette, and one of the few palettes that can actually really carry off saturated colors. When I say saturated is red. It's the primary colors like yellow, like you're wearing today, and also black. And very few of the other palettes can wear black without looking completely washed out, including myself.
Exactly. And what's going to really make you shine on stage is your best color. So I want to ask you how you address these women's needs, because this is part of your business. This is a big part of your business, and you have a specific formula around it. So I wanted you to talk about it, if you could, to let who's ever watching here know what you have to offer when it comes to helping these women entrepreneurs show up better in their style.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Well, here's the thing. You can't separate out style from the whole, from the whole image, because to me, the image that you portray is not just the clothes that you put on. It's like we're not going to win what we want if we just put anything on. It's just not going to happen. So what comes with that is energy. Your energy, your personality, whether you're an extrovert or dynamic, or an introvert and very quiet, whether your mood is high, whether your mood is a bit low. So there is an image, there is your style, your energy, and also your message, actually what you're selling, the way that you're selling it, what you are putting out into the world, and what your promises to people. So image is an alignment of those three elements. It's an alignment of those three elements. So in my style to sell work, which is also called Beautifully Paid, BU,
Beautifully
Paid,
I love it.
I use a system of archetypes. Because and they're visionary women archetypes. They're not like Greek goddesses or archetypes that women can't relate to. They're actually modern leader women leaders. So I have 12 archetypes, and the first thing that we do is to, after defining your objectives, is like what do you want your style to do? What do you want it to say? Is to define their archetypes, because the archetypes actually represent those values that I was talking about in the beginning, and it's the values that people will tune into. And shall I give you an example of my archetypes?
Yes, please.
Okay, so there are 12 archetypes. My three archetypes are rock diva rebel, Duchess influencer, and sporty adventurer. So,
totally.
How does that translate into my style? Well, first of all, the sporty adventurer—that's obvious. I've got camo on. Mm-hmm.
And you are a sporty adventurer.
I am a sporty adventurer. However, this is a little dress. This is a little slinky dress. So this isn't, this isn't just some big baggy sloppy camo t-shirt. This is actually a very feminine little dress. And then I've got this is my Duchess touch. They're always got jewels and always polished. What have I got on the...
You've got your earrings are always mismatched. And that's a very rebellious kind of way.
Always mismatched.
That's a trademark for Jenny. This, every time you see one of our interviews, she's always got the mismatch, but they always are perfectly matched. Mismatched, but perfect.
So when you've got your three archetypes, when we figured those out, and you then curate your wardrobe with pieces like that, If you put them together, you never, ever, ever have to think about matching things, or, they just go together naturally, because they're an expression of your unique style.
I love it. And also it would work out so well, like if you had a specific call you were having to make and you really wanted to call up a certain archetype to be more present in that call, you could really base your wardrobe that day on something that's, so every outfit's a power outfit, which is, I love that in a wardrobe. I like to, everything to make me feel like I could just run into anybody on the street and I would be totally on point. That's a really great, the archetypes are really, really, it's a powerful exercise that you take people through for that. I've been through it and I think it's really powerful. we've been talking about image relating to brand, but is there anything that we haven't touched on in regards to how a woman's image relates to her brand that you wouldn't want anyone to miss out on? Or, I mean, I feel like we've been talking about it, but I just want to make sure.
Well, here's a couple of things that women can do straight away.
Great.
First of all, is to use your journal or a piece of paper and to ask yourself the question, how do I want people to respond to me? Is when I get into a conversation, a connection, you know, a conversation after a DM, or I get on a social media live, everybody's doing social media lives now. If I get on a social media live, what do I want? How do I want people to respond to me? And what action do I want them to take? How can I dress for that to happen? Yeah. So that is a really, really, really good question to ask yourself.
Can you ask it one more time, because your Wi-Fi went out a little bit? So can you just kind of ask that question one more time? Because it kind of warbled a little bit. So
the question you want to ask you is, like, everybody must, if they're an entrepreneur, you have got to be in public. You've got to be out in the world. Mm-hmm. Mostly at the moment, the way the world's going, it's through this sort of connection, through social media lives. Every entrepreneur knows how important it is to do social media lives. Is to ask yourself and then journal on it, how do I want people to respond to me? When I go live, how do I want people to respond to me? And what action do I want them to take as a result of me going live? Is how do I want people to respond to me? And then to ask yourself, actually, to go to your wardrobe or closet and look in there and actually ask yourself, do my clothes represent what I want, how I want people to respond? And you just gave that wonderful example of you want to be a powerhouse so that you can get up and you know, manage the world every single day, which is power dressing. Is if you go to your wardrobe and you go, no, no, it's a real mismatch.
Yes.
So it will start by doing some really self-loving curation of what no longer works for you. You know, stuff you've had for too long that you're absolutely fed up with, stuff that is starting to wear out, it doesn't excite you, or clothes that really don't equate to your highest self, where you're going, your most successful vision for your life. Is that's what you should have in your wardrobe. And it doesn't have to cost a fortune, as we know. It's not a budget thing. But it is taking the care to make sure that all of your outfits, all of your clothes really do speak your message and portray who you are and what you have to offer.
I love it. So ask yourself the question, what are you trying to portray? You know, what are you hoping to get out of it? Go in your wardrobe, ask your wardrobe what, you know, if it's there, and if not, do a lot of purging, which I think is already a great idea, because you're letting go to let more in. So that's really, really key. There's so many outdated things in wardrobes, like that first suit people get for their interviews. Let that go. It's not a good thing. Is there anything else in this subject? I think we've hit everything, but I want to make sure if there's anything else that you want us to know about. And then I want to talk a little bit about the House of Preeminence magazine. But just in this particular subject of image, if I've missed something, please let me know. And you know, in this, what came up for me through this that I think would be great for you is the science of style. You know, so it's just like, I feel like we've caught it. But if there's anything I'm missing, please let me know. And then if not, can you tell us about the House of Preeminence magazine? I talk about it a lot because I'm one of the executive contributors, but I would love to hear it from, if you could let my audience know, as the founder of this beautiful, you know, amazing platform.
Okay, so first of all, if what I've talked about resonates with your audience, they can go to my website and download the Style to Sell mini training class, which is on the front page. And I'll give you the, okay, it's basically jenny-p.com, Jenny with an I.
I'll put all the links in this so you know, just so you guys don't have to write anything.
Just when you land on the page, that there is an audio class that you can listen easily while you're, you know, going for a walk, which is called Style to Sell. And it goes into everything I've been talking a little bit deeper. So that's a resource that people can have straight away. And then the other resource is obviously the House of Preeminence magazine, because this whole topic is fundamental. It's a feminine high performance magazine, and this topic is fundamental to women's success. So for example, in there this month, I have actually talked about the archetypes and why they're so powerful. I've also talked about color. As you know, I talk about color. I take a color every month and talk about the importance of color in your branding, in your marketing, in your style, mm-hmm. and messaging. So there's everything I've talked about, plus all of the brilliance from you and the other contributors on the other areas of marketing and feminine high performance, including wellness, including beauty, including recipes, including articles about speaking. We have absolutely everything in this magazine. So here's what's special, super special about it, apart from being incredibly beautiful, is that this magazine is more than just information. This magazine actually activates your success. Mm-hmm. It actually is designed to activate your success. It's an experience. It's almost like a kind of dynamic meditation where you go in and multi-sensory, fed with beautiful images and amazing content, and you come out on a high, and that is what we all need, is to have our preeminence activated. And the other really key thing that makes this magazine so unique is that we don't take just strategy and tactics. We take the whole spectrum of marketing elements and tools, including mindset, including energy, including, you know, quantum messaging, and we put those together so that women now they've got both sides of the equation. So any women struggling with with one part of their marketing, mm-hmm. they've got the whole caboodle in there. They've got the whole holistic picture building a successful business and a preeminent life.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a total accelerator. And one thing I'd like to mention too is that with a subscription, not only are you getting this beautiful magazine, it's a bi-monthly magazine, but we also have bi-monthly events. On the month the magazine has come out, the month before, the next month we do a webinar. So with every magazine, with every subscription, you're also getting this webinar that we do. They're always so good. And on top of all of that, there's a Facebook page, so you can actually really start building bonds with the actual contributors and yourself, which is amazing. So I'm seeing such growth in the women that are not only part of the magazine, but the women who are subscribing already. Like, it's just amazing. But I'm also seeing people's styles change, and that's exciting. Like, I'm seeing people really resonate with your message. So, you know, I will put all of the links in this. So there's just, you have access to everything. You can reach out to Jenny. You can subscribe to the magazine. You can join the Facebook. There's like a bunch of wonderful things to do. But I just want to thank you, Jenny, because this was a great conversation and just so inspiring. And I really hope that you reach out and contact Jenny about this, because those archetypes alone are going to be a game changer for you. So thank you so much, Jenny, for taking the time. You know I love you. And I look forward to our next conversation, which will be really, really good. But I want to thank you for this one, all about image. It's a really important thing.
Thank you.
You guys, you're welcome. Everyone have a great day. Thank you so much. Oh, hold on a second. Thank you.